गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट ज्योग्राफी अगेन एंड दिस इज चैप्टर 6 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द रॉक्स एंड रॉक साइकिल। एज यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन्स, सो लेट्स सी हियर। नाउ एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो द आवर प्लैनेट एक्चुअली हैज 3 रिंग्स, दैट इज एटमॉस्फेयर, that is a gaseous form, hydrosphere, that is the whole liquid called the water bodies, and lithosphere, that is the solid state. The word litho in Latin means rock. So this word litho actually is derived from a Latin word which means rock. So this way, this whole layer, the solid layer of the earth, or you can say all the continents, they all are called lithosphere. And even you can find this layer is also found in the ocean floor. So this lithosphere also can be called as a rockosphere. Well, first of all, before we start these rocks, I would like to show you the classification of rocks, because already in previous class you have studied about the rocks and you have some information, some knowledge already you are having what you have studied in the previous class. So let's see here again, and first of all I will tell you about the classification of rocks. And look here, as it is given here, the rocks can be classified first of all in 3 types. What are they? The first is the igneous rocks, which is also known as primary rocks. Second is the sedimentary rocks, which we call secondary rock, but it's secondary rock number 1. And the third rock is the metamorphic rocks, which is also a secondary rock number 2. So these are the 3 types of rocks. What are they? Let's see again. Igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. In the whole chapter you will be going to study about these 3 types of rocks, and you are going to study about the some more deeper knowledge about the each of them, different types of igneous rocks, different types of sedimentary rocks and different types of metamorphic rocks and their characteristics, how they are formed. And you will study about the rock cycle, that how these rocks, they are connected to each other. So before we start the types of rock, let me explain you the difference between the rocks and minerals. Because if you will see, the rock contains many minerals. So rock actually can also be defined as the aggregate of minerals. In a very simple language we can say that the rocks actually are the aggregate of minerals. So that is what formed by one or maybe more or less definite unit of the earth's crust, and they may contain many different types of mineral. So what is rock and what is mineral? First of all, let's see this. Now when we talk about the rock, and if you can take any type of rock, there are so many examples are there, like granite is a one type of rock, basalt, marble is a one type of rock, gneiss is a one type of rock, then syenite is a one type of rock. There are different types of rock you will study. But if you just take any rock, and you will find they may contain many different types of mineral. But what do you mean by the minerals then? So minerals actually are the definite element. Now when we talk about mineral, example, if we talk about iron, so iron actually is a single element. Aluminium is a single element. But again, if you take example of bauxite, now bauxite actually is a ore from which aluminium is extracted. But bauxite actually is formed in open as a rock. So bauxite actually is a rock which may contain many types of mineral. Well, aluminium is the major mineral that's found in bauxite, and the amount of other minerals are very, very less. So this is one example of one rock. Now bauxite is the one rock which is also called the ore, because the major element or mineral which is found in bauxite is aluminium. So now this bauxite is extracted from the different places where they are found. Now usually you will find aluminium actually is present everywhere. Even in the soil you will find some amount of aluminium is found, but the amount of aluminium is so less that if we just separate the aluminium from the soil or sand, it can be very expensive. This is why when to extract aluminium, actually usually the people, they find out the ore or the rocks which contains large amount of aluminium. So the rocks which contains large amount of aluminium, and beside the aluminium there are even other minerals are also found in that rock. But because that rock contains much larger amount of aluminium, so that rock is called bauxite. So first of all, the bauxite is extracted from the different mines wherever they are found, and it is brought to the factory, aluminium factory, and then this aluminium is separated from this ore. Well, so I am telling you one example that how, what do you mean by the rock and what do you mean by the mineral. So mineral, actually in a simple language we can say that mineral actually is a single element, but the rocks, they are the aggregate of minerals. So they may contain many different types of mineral, or maybe sometimes some special mineral can be found in that rock in more larger quantity. Well, another thing, now if you find about the mineral, mineral has a very definite chemical composition. So every mineral, if you take the example of iron, or when we can take the example of copper or gold, or maybe already we have seen aluminium. Now each differ in chemical composition and even in the physical properties. So every mineral, they actually have a definite chemical composition as well as physical properties. But what do you mean by the rocks? Now rocks don't have the any definite chemical composition or physical properties. Why? Because they contain many minerals. So this is a major difference between the rocks and mineral. So this is a very common questions which can be asked in examination. that define or differentiate between the rocks and mineral. So this can be of 3 marks or 2 marks. So now let's start here. The first rock, that is igneous rocks. But before we start the igneous rocks, I would like to show you one figure. And the section of the earth, the lithosphere. So as you can find here on your screen. And here if you'll find here, this is one cross section of the earth. And you can find here, these are the different layers. So this is earth, you can find already, you have studied about the interior structure of the earth. So this is the crust, then this is the mantle, then this is the outer core, inner core. So if you find here actually one cross section is drawn here. So you can find here that already we have seen already in the previous chapter about the thickness of each layers. So you can find here, that is first of all the thickness of the inner core starts from 5100 kilometer to 6378 kilometer. Then now this is a solid part, as I explained you that the inner core actually is a very solid part. As you, some of you know that the interior part of the earth in the center, it is a liquid, but actually it is not found in a liquid form. Why? That I explained you, because of the very very high density. Because of the very high density, it is impossible for any mineral to be present in liquid form. This is why, even though the temperature is highest here in the interior part, this layer actually is a very solid part. Now above this core, this layer, as you can see, mantle, here actually is liquid. Well, it is shown here liquid only, but actually the lower part up to some places they can be solid also, and usually liquid you can find in the upper part of the mantle. So upper part of the mantle, well, you can see here. Then again you can find here the upper part, here the most upper part, that is crust. Crust has two layers, the upper crust and the lower crust. So you can find here first of all the thickness. So you will find here the thickness of crust actually is very less. As I told you, the upper crust, the thickness of the upper crust is only 30 kilometer. But as you go down, the thickness of the mantle and the core, even the different, the two layers of mantle, right, and the two layers of core, actually they are much thicker. Well, so when we talk about the lithosphere, as we have already seen, litho means rock, rockosphere or lithosphere. So we are dealing about the only upper layer, we are not dealing with the mantle or core, but here in this chapter we are dealing only with the upper layer of the earth crust, that is called lithosphere. So let's start here with the first rock, that is the igneous rocks. So as you can find here on your screen, igneous rocks. So first thing is how these igneous rocks are formed. This is the first question. How the igneous rocks are formed? Now usually, already as I shown you, that igneous rocks are also called primary rocks. Why they are called primary rocks? Because igneous rocks, they directly formed by the solidification of the molten magma. Now what happened when the, as you can find here is the one figure of volcano is shown. So what happens? The molten material inside the earth is called magma. But when this magma comes above the surface, then we call it lava. That is difference in the words. Now, so this way, we have come to know that when this magma solidifies, they forms what? Igneous rocks. This is why, as you can find that the igneous rocks, they are formed by the solidification of magma. And that's why we call it, what? We call them primary rocks. We call them primary rocks. Okay. Now next. So here one thing more you can see in this figure. This magma sometimes it solidifies inside the crust. Now this is a magma chamber. So sometimes in this chamber, this magma can be solidified. Sometimes they can enter in the cracks, as you can find here. These are the vents. Sometimes in the vent they solidifies. As you can see, this here are the horizontal cracks. These magma enters in these cracks and they solidify. So, but sometimes, most of the time, they comes above the surface of the earth and then here they solidifies. So, first of all, this magma, when it comes above the surface, as I explained to you, they are called lava. So, they forms extrusive igneous rocks. Extrusive means above the surface. The igneous rocks above the surface of the earth. Now, when they solidifies inside the crust, now what we call them? So, all these rocks here, as you can find here, these whole, all the rocks, we call them intrusive igneous rocks. So, this is the two types of igneous rocks. First is the extrusive igneous rocks. Second is intrusive igneous rocks. Now, first of all, let's see the two types of magma. Now, magma can be of two types. Now, how they can be of two types, let's see here. Some magma, they contains less amount of silicate. So, when the magma, they contains less amount of silicate, we call them basic igneous rocks. What do you call them? We call them basic igneous rocks. Now here in your book actually that only explained about the how they can be different. The first one, as you can see here, the basalt magma, which is very very hot and highly fluid. So the magma actually which is hot and highly fluid, but they also contains less amount of silicate. This is also one important characteristic and most important characteristic. So these magma which contains less amount of silicate, and because they contains less amount of silicate, they are very very hot and highly fluid. So when they come above the surface of the earth, so they starts flowing as a river. They can flow at a very very large distance. And these magma, as I told you, above the surface they are called lava. So these lava is called acidic lava. But another type of magma which actually very very high silicate, the magma, as I told you, when it comes above the surface we call them lava. So the lava which contains very high silicate we call them acidic lava. What do you call them? We call them acidic lava. As you can find here, the temperature is about 850 degrees centigrade, and this type of lava is very highly viscous. Viscous in the sense actually, they contain heat for a very very long time. They don't flow. Now they are not in liquid, they are very very thick. But what happens? They solidify, the solidification actually well takes very quickly, but they can contain the heat for a very very long period. They don't radiate the heat very easily. That's why they are very, very viscous. Okay. So, these are the two types of lava. The first is the
basic lava which contains less amount of silicate, and the second which contains high amount of silicate, the magma which contains high amount of silicate, they are the acidic lava. So two types of magma or lava, because magma when it comes above the surface, we call them, what do you call them? Here you look here the picture, we call them lava. So the two types of lava is acidic lava and basic lava. Now look here, some I want to show you some pictures of some igneous rocks. As you can find here, this is the picture of syenite rock. There is another picture of granite rock, and here is a basalt rock. As you can find here above, how they are formed? They are formed by the lava flow. As the lava, as you can find here, it is solidifying here. So large part you can see already have developed into the rocks, but here you can find still it contains the heat. It is a viscous, you can see here. So solidification is taking place here. So this is about the igneous rocks. Now let's see here some detailed study about the types of igneous rocks. So now here you can find here the types of igneous rocks. The igneous rocks can be classified, as you can find here, there are the some basics. This is our a very, very important point. You may remember. Look here. Igneous rocks are classified on the basis of texture of grains, chemical composition and mode of origin. So now this question can be asked. This is a very important question. How the igneous, or by on which basis the igneous rocks can be classified? So the answer will be on the basis of texture of grains, number 2 chemical composition, and number 3 mode of origin. So these simple things you need to remember. So these type of questions, and as I am explaining you the chapter, I will also tell you some common questions which will be asked in the board examination. So here you can find here number 1 on the basis of silica present. Already we have seen the two types of lava. What are they? Acidic lava and basic lava. So what happened when the acidic lava it solidifies, they forms acidic igneous rocks. Now example is granite. Granite contains more silica. Second is the basic lava. So the basic lava when it solidifies, they are called basic igneous rocks. And as you can see one example, gabbro. Gabbro is one example of igneous rocks. They contains lower quantity of silica. So these are the two categories. The igneous rocks can be kept into two categories. On which basis? On the basis of silica present. Now next basis is the occurrence. Occurrence means where they solidifies. So here you can find on the basis of occurrence igneous rocks, they are divided into the two category. What are they? Number 1 is intrusive and second is the extrusive. Already I explained you. So let's see here. First of all, about the intrusive igneous. Intrusive means, let me show you the picture here. So here this figure, as you can find, and already I explained you, the magma when it solidifies inside the crust, we call them intrusive igneous rocks. Very simple. Now let's see the further classification of intrusive igneous rocks. Now so let me show you here the figure already. So you can find here this igneous rocks again is classified into two types. Now what are they? Now if you find here, this is a magma chamber, and when the magma solidifies in this chamber, we call it plutonic igneous rocks. In the full form we will call it plutonic intrusive igneous rocks. Which rocks are called plutonic rocks? When the magma solidifies inside the chamber, then they forms plutonic intrusive
igneous rocks. But when the magma solidifies above, it comes outside this chamber, and sometimes, as you can see here, it solidifies in this vent, or this is another vent. So when it solidifies in the another vent, and you can see here, it is not vertical, right? So this structure, when it solidifies, it is called dike. And here you can see here the magma has entered in the crack, and here it is called sill. So these rocks, we call it first of all hypobasal intrusive igneous rocks. So like way, this is way, the intrusive igneous rocks again can be classified into two types. What are they? The first one is the, as you can see, plutonic igneous rocks. As I told you, they origin where? In the magma chamber. Second is the, so plutonic rock is given here. Some examples are also shown here. You can find here some examples like gabbro, granite and batholith. These are the examples of some plutonic rocks. Now, next is the, I told you, hypobasal rocks. So which rocks are called hypobasal? When these rocks solidifies in the upper layer of crust, they are called hypobasal igneous rocks. Okay, now again, these igneous rocks, actually, because what happens, as I already shown you on the figure, these igneous rocks actually, they just forms a different type of shape inside the crust. Which type of shape? Some shape I have shown you, let me just show you again. Now here, if you see here, this magma enters in this crack. So in the horizontal layer, these rocks are formed inside the crust. So this structure is called sill. But when these magma solidifies in the vertical, in this another vent, right? Or so what happens? We call them dikes. So let's see here some important things, some important intrusive igneous rocks. The first is the batholith. This is the one type of intrusive igneous rocks. Now what are the batholith? Well, second is laccolith, then sill, then stock, dikes. So these are some examples. Already I shown you dikes, I shown you sills, also I shown you, and batholith, laccolith and stocks. Let me find out and then I will show you. Now here I would like to show you another figure where I will show you the some different structure of intrusive igneous rocks. As I told you, this magma, when they solidifies inside the crust of the earth, so what happens? They solidifies in different shape, and these different shapes are known by different names. So let's see here. First of all, I have shown you the batholith. Now very deep inside the earth, in the magma chamber, when the magma solidifies in a very very big region, so that is called batholith. Second is, as you can find here, the magma solidifies in the upper layer of crust, but you can find it is a shape of mushroom, and this shape we call it laccolith. Then when the magma enters in horizontal cracks and they solidifies, so these igneous rocks are called sills. You can find here, these are the sills. Okay, then next is the stock. Now you can find here, batholith is a very very big layers inside the, deep inside the earth. Usually actually it is in the lower crust or upper mantle. When this magma solidifies in an area of more than 100 square kilometer, they forms batholith. But what happens when this magma comes above in the upper layer of the crust, and they just forms a big structure like this. So this structure is called stock. Then when the magma solidifies in the vent, then what we call? We call them dikes. Well, two more structures are there. So we will see afterwards in the another chapter, volcano. Volcano, you will, we're going to see it. Okay. So these are some common things which I already I have shown you. So these are the pictures. Now let's come, let's go back there to the rock again. So already we have seen about the intrusive igneous rocks. Now the second type of igneous rocks are, as you can see there on your screen, this is extrusive igneous rocks. Now I already explained you, when the magma comes above the surface of the earth, what we call them? We call them lava. Now when they solidifies, we call them extrusive igneous rocks. Now again, these extrusive igneous rocks, they can be of two types. What are they? Let's see. So these can be, because this type actually is classified according to the nature of lava, on the basis of nature of lava. So all of you know, when the volcano erupts, they erupts in two forms, sometimes in explosive form and mostly very quietly. From the cracks the magma comes out. So these are the two types, explosive type, quiet type. But when this magma comes out in explosive way, what happens? First of all, the ashes comes out, then the lava also comes out, and this lava mixed with the ash and they solidifies and they forms the igneous rocks. So these rocks, which because they also contains, or you can say the mixture of the ash and lava. So the structure, composition of these igneous rocks are somewhat different. That's why we call them explosive type of extrusive igneous rocks. Second, when the magma comes out quietly from some cracks, so there is no ash is found in those rocks. They are pure igneous rocks, lava, they solidifies and they forms the igneous rocks. So we call them quiet type of extrusive igneous rocks. These are the two types of extrusive igneous rocks. Now let's see about the characteristics of the igneous rocks. As you can find here on your screen. And let's see here one by one, because today I don't want to start the second type because I think it will become too much for you. And let's just take it in a small portion. So today only I will explain you only about the igneous rocks. So next session I will explain you about the sedimentary rock. And like this, we'll just move very slowly. So let's see here first of all the characteristics of igneous rocks. Now already as I explained you, the first characteristic, as you can see, they are also called primary rocks. Why? Because they are formed by the molten magma, solidification of molten magma, and that's why we call them the primary rocks also. Second thing, these igneous rocks, they do not occur in distinct bed. What do you mean by the bed? Bed means strata. Strata means layer. How? Let me explain you. Now during the flood, if you'll find the river, they deposit the silt over the bank of the river. So they are deposited in a one layer. Next flood, again another layer is deposited. In many places, when these layers, they solidifies, they form the sedimentary rock. So sedimentary rocks, actually they are usually formed in layers. So when we start the sedimentary rock, we will come to know they are formed in layers. So usually you will, when you will see about the sedimentary rock, you will find they are in layers. But actually here igneous rocks are not found in any layers. They are not, never occur in layers. So what happens? They solidifies, right? And they become very, very hard rock. Second thing. Third is, they are not fossiliferous. What do you mean by the fossiliferous? Fossiliferous means fossils are not found in these rocks. What are the fossils? When, especially when you find, take the example of the sedimentary rock. Now usually during the excavation, many places, very, very old, the fossil of some animal or human beings, they are the skeleton and everything, even the remains of the some very, very old plants and the trees are also, sometimes when they are covered with the layers of the rock, so they are called fossils. We will going to see about the fossil in the next rock, sedimentary rock. So here actually igneous rocks, they don't contain any fossils, so they are not fossiliferous. Fourth one, they are generally very hard and water percolate in them with great difficulty. What does it mean? Means they don't allow water to pass. They don't allow the water, because you will find the example of sedimentary rocks, so water can pass through some many of the sedimentary rocks. But igneous rocks actually are very, very hard. They are non-porous. So they don't allow the water to pass through them. So they are very, very hard, and water is never percolate, means they never pass through these water. Fifth one, they are granular and crystalline, because as I told you, these rocks, igneous rocks, are formed because of the solidification of the magma. So when the magma solidifies, so what happens? They forms the grains. So that's why they are granular and crystalline. Because sometimes very quick solidification takes place, especially in the acidic rocks. So in that, the rocks are formed, some rocks are formed in crystals. So we call them crystalline. So they can be granular and crystalline. Next is, these are generally weathered by mechanical weathering. Mechanical weathering means these igneous rocks, they can be weathered by the agents of wind or by the agents of running water. So they are the mechanical process of weathering. You will study afterwards. Next is, most of the igneous rocks, they consist silicate. So first thing, they contain silicate. Maybe the amount of silicate can be less or more. On that basis, they can be categorized into acidic igneous rocks and basic igneous rocks, but they contain silicate. And the last point, these acidic, not only acidic, because let me explain you first of all, acidic. So the igneous rocks, which are usually acidic in nature most of the time, they contains many minerals also, like iron ore, gold, silver, zinc, lead, aluminium, manganese, mica, etc. Now what about the basic igneous rocks? Basic igneous rocks actually, after a very long time, they go through the process of weathering and they can turn into a fertile lava soil. Example, in South India, there is a Deccan Plateau in Maharashtra and Karnataka. And this Deccan Plateau actually is formed by the weathering of the lava rocks. That's why black soil is found there. So black soil actually is an example of lava soil. And lava soil is very, very fertile. And especially which lava soil? Basic. The basic lava, when they solidify, means basic igneous rocks, when they solidifies, they may form very, very fertile soil. Example I told you, one example is a black soil which is found there on the Deccan Plateau of India.
Another example is the Terra Rosa soil. If you remember, you have studied about the South America, Brazil, on the Brazilian highland, there is a red soil is found. That is which type of soil? This red soil is a lava soil. So it is rich in iron, because iron content is very high there, that's why it looks red in color, and usually we call them Terra Rosa, if you remember. So the igneous rocks here, as I told you, usually they contain many minerals like iron ore, gold, silver, zinc, lead, aluminium, magnesium, manganese and mica, etc. While the basic lava, after the weathering, they can form very, very fertile lava soil. So today this much only. All the best. Okay. And your homework is to read this chapter, whatever thing is left. So all of you just go through the book, those who are having the book. So goodbye.